But hi guys, we're going to do a little session for you guys today.
So the first thing what we're going to do is we're going to have Pallavi's hair a little wet, wetter than what it is now. So we don't have Flarisol bottles. If you have it, you can use that. So right now we're just going to use one patila of water. Okay, so I style my hair upside down, like an upside down pineapple cake. So that's what we're going to do with Pallavi now.
Upside down pineapple cake. It sounds like a dessert. So I need to put my hair like this.
Okay. Come back. So. Yeah. Now it's in the frame. Okay. So I'm just going to take some water and just make sure the hair has enough. A lot of water. Yeah. Alright. Her hair is already detangled, so make sure you have your hair detangled before you style. You can also use your leave-in to detangle your hair. Today we're going to use the Mysonia hair cream.
The dog is upset.
It's a child.
Oh, no, that's not a child. That can't be a child. It is a child. Clearly, guys, I know nothing about motherhood. I'm sorry.
So I'm taking more hair cream and ensuring we have more water on the hair while we do it.
My hair loves curl creams. Loves like stylers, heavy cream and stuff.
So wish we had your denim now.
Yeah, I was thinking of getting it now. Like for me, even a normal comb works for that. Like just anything to distribute the product and it's like better.
Chal, let's do it. Okay. I have a white tooth comb.
Likewise. So glad this worked out though, okay? Like I'm here for only a couple of days. And I met her a couple of days ago in the cafe, Starbucks, no?
Yeah. Don't promote Starbucks, they don't pay you.
Don't pay us, don't pay.
So you can like style on damp hair as well, right Liz? Mm-hmm. I mean like,
yeah. So since we're talking about low porosities, Pallavi has low porosity, I have high porosity. There are different methods of styling. You just have to try different methods and see what works for you.
Yeah. There's no like, this is the only way to do if you have low porosity hair. Like, don't go with that little panda.
We're going to continue to praying hands the cream in. I'm sorry, your neck is going to bend.
Oh, no, that's okay. I think it's really sweet.
Okay, definitely not raking in at this point at all. Because we already put the brush, the comb in. So we're not raking in, it'll just disturb the clumps. Careful. Okay. So my routine is that after I apply a leave-in or a curl cream, I block. So that's what we're going to try on Pallavi now. Okay. Is it on your forehead?
Yeah, it's on my forehead. This is a proper microfiber towel, right?
Yeah.
You can do it with a t-shirt if you have one at home, but a proper towel will soak it faster. Will dry it faster. Cool. Very attractive.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so what this method does is that it gives the curls
some
pressure to stay in that curl pattern, and because it has cream or leave-in in it, it has that product to stay that way, and you can totally edit this out. Okay.
All right. So we're gonna keep this on for how long? 5-10 minutes.
Yeah. You can, depending on how wet your hair was, the wetter it was, the longer you keep it. But since this was just damp hair right now, we'll just keep it like 5 minutes or 10 minutes max. We don't want to dry the hair out. We just want
just sort of like a small cast to form and the curls to like start forming a little bit.
Yeah, right? Yeah. So therefore, encouraging curl clumping. In this stage. Okay, so we had this plop on for like, I think 5 minutes.
Yeah.
You can keep it longer, again, depending on how wet your hair is or not. If you have migraine issues, don't plop. So now what we're going to do is we're going to take the plop out and apply a gel.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
You want to like go close up and
yeah,
go
so
show them.
This is how it looks right now. Shiny and a little clumped.
So we're going to use the flaxseed gel by Mysonier. And not too much. Not too much. Just that's it. And take a little bit of water. Just make sure your hair, your palms have some water so the gel emulsifies. So that way you don't have to use more product. Use more water. And we go in with praying hands.
So do you comb after gel this?
Yeah. And notice I apply a gel or any product for that matter like about 2 inches away from my scalp.
So there's more volume at the crown.
Yes.
Nice.
So we'll just spend some time with the praying hands method just to get that curl clumping happening. Just taking a tiny bit more. Get this side.
Like depending on your hair, like vary the quantities. Like I think a beginner mistake everybody makes is they use too little conditioner and too little leave-in. But like you can obviously go overboard as well. So keep, try a couple of different amounts and then you'll find what suits you best.
Absolutely. That applies for every step of the process. Styling is like the last step. Okay. I think everybody's got some.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Ooh.
Just at the crown area a little bit. Okay, so now after applying the gel in the praying hands method, I'll take a little bit more gel.
Focus.
Okay. And water to scrunch. And don't scrunch too much. Don't be a mad person. And scrunch in pumping motion.
Crunch and pump. I love that noise.
Right?
Squelching. That's the name. That's the word. Squelch, squelch, squelch.
Yeah. You have to have that sound. If you don't have that sound, go and get more water in your palms and scratch. And go gently, okay? Don't scrunch like a caveman. Go section-wise, be gentle. Okay. Now, I still have so much of gel that came out. So, now is the time you decide your parting.
This way? This. Is this the way?
Yeah. So whatever is left over, you take and then you just little bit over here. Because this is where the frizzies come, right? So just gently, just on top. Okay. and then we'll scrunch again with the microfiber towel.
It's so nice to have somebody else do this for you.
At this point, I put the clips. This is called the root clipping method. And this is to lift up the roots and give you more volume.
Ooh, I don't think I do these right.
Sometimes they don't stay on their own, so you have to put two. So you can crisscross to like give it a little more weight, like this. Physics happening right now.
Oh, this, it's got a nice hold.
Mm-hmm. And it's a great way to actually get your scalp dry faster too. Because it's got all that space.
Like, I use those other duckbill clips, like the normal ones, mm-hmm. but they, like, the weight of my hair doesn't, like, stand up, like how this is, like, holding it in place. That's a big difference.
Come here closer so they can. Can you see? This is one clip, and then this. Okay. And then you put it crisscross, like this. Clips are in, this one's falling, so. Okay. It's important to have the clips going before we dry it, so that it dries in that shape. Okay. So,
alright,
we're going to diffuse now, and you can use your favorite diffuser to diffuse. And don't diffuse on heat, diffuse on cold setting. But
actually,
right,
you don't even use a little bit of heat, like at the beginning.
We do. So, getting to it. So, since we are hard pressed for time, we're going to use the heat setting. But it's not going to affect the hair if you do it once in a while.
Yeah, we take so much care already. Like, it's.
Guys, so I'm gonna air dry the rest of it, and then I'll show you the results after it's fully done.
So my routine is inspired by the Laura's method. Pallavi should link her profile below. You should look at her videos also. So this is what she does. But the only difference is that I don't use as much product as she does, and I apply my products away from my scalp. So that's the only difference.
Yay.
So after your hair is fully dry and you scrunch out the cast,
yeah,
you can separate your coils also.
So pretty. Like, shake it out. Shake it.
So it falls in place.
Anyway, like after it dries, I sort of just flip it over to the other side. There's like massive volume, like out of nowhere.
But don't flip it now,
right?
Because
now.
It's dry. It's still dry. Yay. Cool.
Alright.
Yeah.
So like Liz's routine is on her channel and on her Instagram. I'm gonna link everything so you guys can follow her. She does detailed daily updates of different products she's using, so that's like it's like a powerhouse of information, and you don't need to read all her blog posts for it. There's a ton of it on the on Instagram as well.
Yeah.
And she has a YouTube channel as well, so you can see her styling her curls each step of the way. So I'll link that as well. Yeah.
Hope you like this. Bye.
Bye, guys.
Hi guys. So my hair is almost fully dry, and if you can see, it's really like it looks very crispy, like, you know, crispy noodles. That's because the gel has formed like such a nice cast around it that it's hardened, and that's what's supposed to happen. Okay, so you need to break that cast after your hair is fully dry. Don't do it on when your hair is like semi wet or damp or anything. You need to wait for it to get completely dry, otherwise you'll have more frizz. And then to like get more volume and not make it look so stiff, I'm going to scrunch out the crunch, or SOTC is what it's called usually. Now I didn't carry oil with me on this trip, so the only thing I have is like a face oil, so I'm going to use that. It's better if you use like a light oil, like grapeseed, or sorry, grapeseed is quite heavy, like jojoba or like almond or argan oil. I usually use righteous roots. That's in my house. So you need to just do this. Just see how like now that the cast is breaking, it's become more like voluminous. I'm going to fluff out my roots as well so that there's like, and there you go.